Yes, good morning, student. Welcome in the lecture 8, chapter 3, pair of linear equation in two variable of class 10. Now, whatever you have studied in the pair of linear equation in two variable, that concept we will be using in the word problem. Now, in word problem, you are seeing that the problem applications of linear equations are there. Whenever we read the question, now the you have to form an equation, and for to make pair of linear equation, two condition will be given to you. According to that, you have to form two equation. Now the here question is that the difference between two number is 26 and one number is 3 times the other. Find them. Now difference is always what? That is larger number minus smaller number. So what you will do? That is, we can take larger number as x and smaller number be y. That is first condition. You write, let the larger number be x and let the smaller number be y. And according to problem, what you will say, x minus y equal to 26. Because the difference between two number is 26. And after that it is given, one number is 3 times the other. That is, larger number is 3 times the smaller number. So larger number is x, x equal to 3y. That is the second equation. Now to solve these two equation 1 and 2, you can use any method. Elimination by equating the coefficient method or elimination by substitution method. It depends on you by which method you want to solve. Here x equal to 3y is there. You put the value in equation number 1. After that you will get the value of y, and put the value of y in equation number 2. You will get the value of x. And this is how we can write larger number is 39 and smaller number is 13. Now in this question, supplementary angles, and you know what is supplementary angles, that is sum of two angle is 180 degree. Now question may be of complementary angles. So complementary angle is what? Sum of two angle is 90 degree. Now here the question is what? Let the larger one angle be x, that is larger angle be x, and other angle will be what? Y. Now this question some student will do in another method, but what we have to do, we have to use two variables. So we are taking one angle x and other angle is y. So equation will be what? X plus y equal to 18. And second equation, that is larger angle is equal to smaller angle plus 18, that is x equal to y plus 18. Y will come to LHS, you will get x minus y equal to 18, second equation. Now two equation you are getting, x plus y equal to 180, x minus y equal to 18. Two equations can be solved by adding equation 1 and 2. So plus y minus y cancel, 2x equal to 198, x equal to 99. Put the value of x in equation number 1, you will get the value of y. So larger angle is 99 and smaller angle is 81. So this is another method to solve the question. Now third question is what? The coach of a cricket team buys 7 bats and 6 balls. Two variables are bats and ball, and they are costing rupees 3800. Later she buys 3 bats and 5 balls for rupees 1750. Find the cost of each bat and each ball. So what you will write? Let the cost of each bat be rupees x and let the cost of each ball be rupees y. So what is, according to problem, 7 bats and 6 ball cost 3800. So you will say 7x plus 6y equal to 3800. 3 bats and 5 balls cost 1750. 3x plus y equal to 1750. That is equation number 2. Another question, very important question, is that the taxi charges in a city consist of fixed charge together with a charge for the distance covered. For a distance of 10 km, the charge paid is rupees 105, and for a journey of 15 km, the charge paid is rupees 155. What are the fixed charges and the charge per kilometer? What are the fixed charges? So what you will write? Let the fixed charges be rupees x and let the charge per kilometer be rupees y. So here you will write, let the fixed charges be rupees x and let the charge per kilometer be rupees y. How much that is pay for 10 kilometer? X plus 10 y equal to 105 and x plus 15 y equal to 155. after solving this equation 1 and 2 you will get the value of x and y. But further it is given what, how much a person has to pay for 25 km. You will write total charge paid for rupees for 25 km will be what, x plus 25 y. Now in case of another question, now fraction, a fraction becomes 9/11 if 2 is added to both the numerator and the denominator. If 3 is added to both the numerator and denominator, it becomes 5/6. Find the fraction. What I feel is that you always write, let the numerator be x, let the denominator be y, and fraction will be x upon y. Have a practice of writing like this. Don't write directly, let the fraction be x upon y. You can write fraction x upon y. But when we are doing variety of question, you will find that this concept will be very easy to understand. So have a practice of writing this. Let the numerator be x, denominator be y, and fraction will be x upon y. Now 2 is added according to problem. 2 is added to numerator and denominator. So x plus 2 upon y plus 2 equal to 9/11. 3 is added to numerator and denominator. X plus 3 upon y plus 3 equal to 5/6. Cross multiply, you will get equation 1 and equation 2. And you will solve the equation 1 and 2 by any method. So here, after solving equation 1 and 2, you will get the value of x and y, and after that you will write fraction is x upon y. Now 5 years hence, the age questions are there. 5 years hence, the age of Jacob will be 3 times that of his son. 5 years ago, Jacob's age was 7 times that of his son. What are their present ages? First of all, what you will write? Let the present age of Jacob be x years and let the present age of son be y years. This is very important. Now after that you will write 5 years hence, Jacob is what, 3 times son. So 5 years hence, what you will say, x plus 5 equal to 3, y plus 5. That is, you will get the equation x minus 3y equal to 10, first equation. Now 5 years ago, so Jacob will be what, x minus y, and 7 will remain as it is, son will be what, y minus y. So x minus 5 equal to 7y minus 35, x minus 7y equal to minus 35 plus 5, and x minus 7y equal to minus 30, that is second equation. After that, another important question, the ratio of incomes of two persons is 9:7 and the ratio of their expenditure is 4:3. If each of them manages to save rupees 2000 per month, find their monthly income. Let the income of first person be 9x. Let the income of second person 7x, because ratio is given. And after that expenditure, let the expenditure of first person be rupees y and let the expenditure of second person 3y. After that, you know saving, income minus expenditure is saving. So 9x minus 4y equal to 2000, first equation. 7x minus 3y equal to 2000, second equation. You solve these two equations by eliminating the equating coefficient method and get the value of x and y. And in last, you will have to tell income of first person 9 into x, that is, and income of second person, that is 7 into x. You will get the answer. Okay, thank you, and practice these questions in the copy.